Hello guys, welcome to my channel Fundamentals of Engineering. If you are not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. In today's session, we are going to see another angle measuring instrument, that is sine bar. So for measuring the angle, no absolute standard is required. The measurement is done in degrees, minutes and seconds. The measurement of angular and circular divisions is an important part of inspection. It is concerned with the measurement of individual angles, angular changes and deflections on component, gauges and tools. For precise measurement of angles, more skill is required. Like linear measurement, angular measurements have their own importance. So the basic difference between the linear and angular measurement is that no absolute standard is required for angular measurement. So among all the angular measuring instrument, in today's session we are going to see one important angular measuring instrument, that is sine bar. Before starting to this session, I request all of you to subscribe my channel, click on bell icon to get more notifications. So the sine bar is in itself is not a complete measuring instrument. Another datum such as surface plate is needed, as well as another auxiliary equipments like slip gauges and indicating devices is required to make the measurements. Sine bars used to conjunction with slip gauge constitute a very good device for precise measurements of angles. Sine bars are used either to measure angles very accurately or for locating any work to a given angle within close limits. Sine bars are made from high carbon, high chromium, corrosion resistant steels, hardened, ground and stabilized. Two cylinders of equal diameters are attached at the ends. So this is the introduction of sine bar. In today's session, we are going to see what is the working principle of sine bar, working process, how the angle is measured by using a sine bar, that we are going to see. Then what are the merits and demerits, means advantages and disadvantages of this sine bar. So from this picture, you can see a sine bar is a precision angle measuring instrument used along with the slip gauges. So slip gauges are required, also some indicating device also required whenever we are going to measure the angle by using sine bar. So first, setting rollers. These rollers of equal diameters are attached at the ends. The axis of these two rollers are mutually parallel to each other and also parallel to an equal distance from the upper surface of the sine bar. Likely, the distance between the axis of two cylinders is exactly 5 inches or 10 inches in British system and 100, 200 and 300 mm in metric system. So if you want to define any sine bar, that sine bar is defined based on the distance between center distance between these two rollers, that it is given by the value L. So these setting rollers are hardened and equal diameter. Then upper surface is perfectly flat. On this upper surface we are keeping the component whose angle we want to measure. Then all the end faces, side faces and lower faces are squarer to each other and parallel to each other, so that it will give the very much importance for measurement of angle. Also, the relief holes are provided to the sine bar to take the advantages of reducing the weight of sine bar. Also, it can be used for holding the sine bar very accurately. So this is the introduction of sine bar. Now we are going to see working principle of sine bar. So you can see in this figure 1, the sine bar kept on the edge, that is height of slip gauges, and one roller is kept on height of slip gauges and one roller is kept on surface plate. So the principle of operation of sine bar is based upon the application of trigonometry. So in this second figure, you can see the triangle is made up of right angle triangle, in which If we see the ABC right angle triangle, the ratio of length BC, which is perpendicular to the arc length AB. So in this, if you seen the angle theta, that is hypotenuse perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So based on that, H by L, so you can calculate the angle theta. Now, by using this principle, that principle of trigonometry, we are going to measure an angle by using sine bar. So the sine bar is having very good accuracy, and this is depend upon some construction features and maintaining of these construction features. Like the two rollers must have equal diameter and true cylinders. The rollers must be set parallel to each other and to the upper face. The precise center distance between the rollers must be known, and the upper face must have some high degree of flatness. So all these you have to maintain whenever we are going to measure angle by using sine bar. Also, we have to take the precautions whenever we are using the sine bar. We have to clean the sine bar. All the faces should be clean by using some cotton paper. So we have to use, or any dirt particle is there, that we have to remove. Also, the component whose angle we want to measure, that you have to also clean, so that any dust particle will be there, that can be removed. So the upper surface of the sine bar will be kept very good, so that will not hamper the upper surface of the sine bar. So these are the precautions we have to take while measuring the angle by using sine bar. So for measuring the angle of component, unknown angle, for that first we have to find out the approximate angle by using bevel protractor. How to find out the angle by using bevel protractor? If you want more information, in the suggestions you can see the link for the angle measurement for bevel protractor. Also you can see the link of how to measure angle by using bevel protractor in the description box. So there, by using that, we have to measure the angle of a unknown component. That angle will be theta approximate. So based on that theta approximate, we have to calculate the value of h approximate, that is the value of height by using slip gauges. For that we can use the formula earlier shown. In that, h approximate can be calculated by using sine theta, that will be theta approximate, into L. That L is a standard. You can get that value of L on the sine bar also. It is written. Then, based on that H approximate, we are going to select the number of slip gauges from the slip gauge set. So, how to build the dimensions for the slip gauge set, that you can see the suggestion box, the video link. Also, you can see the description. In that, you'll get an idea how to build the dimension for by using slip gauge for the specified length. So by using that, we have to build the height by using minimum number of slip gauges and exact number exact values of slip gauges. So then we have to keep the sine bar in this way, that one roller will be kept on the surface plate. Surface plate is having a very good advantage of flatness and parallelism. So on that surface plate, we have to keep one roller, and another roller we have to keep on the height of slip gauges, which will be H approximates. So this is the height of slip gauges, and on that we have to keep the component whose angle we are going to measure. That based on the theta approximate, we are going to calculate the theta exact. So for this, we have to check the surface of component, top surface of component and surface plate will be parallel to each other. For that, we are going to use the dial indicator. So first position will keep the dial indicator. When we move the dial indicator from first position to second position, then the pointer will not be moved from its initial position. If the pointer is not moving from the initial position, that it will remain on the zero, then there is a possibility that whatever the h approximate we are getting, that will be the h exact. Sometimes there is a movement in the pointer, or sometimes we will see the gap between end faces, end of the dial indicator and the surface of the component, that you have to check. Means you have to exactly match the dial indicator end contact surface on the workpiece. So based on that, you can change the height of slip gauges. You can add or remove based on the pointer movement in the dial indicator. So if these two surface, the red line, if these two surface are parallel to each other, then we can see that we'll get the H exact. So until and unless you are getting these two surface parallel to each other, until that we have to repeat the process till you'll get the H exact. Means whenever the dial indicator moving from position 1 to position 2, that the pointer will remain at 0. So there you'll get H exact. So based on this H exact value, we are going to find out the theta exact. So for that, the formula theta exact is equal to sine inverse of H exact upon L, that is the standard distance L, that is center roller distance between two rollers. So based on that, we can find out angle for this, unknown angle for this component. So this is a small object. For that, we can find out easily by using bevel protractor and with the help of slip gauge and dial indicator, the angle for this. Also, we can use angle plate to clamp the workpiece and the sine bar with this. Sometimes we'll get a larger workpiece, and for that larger workpiece, we are going to measure the angle. For that, we require two dial test indicators. So these dial tool indicators are, we have to keep like this. Earlier we have kept the component on the sine bar, so for that small size we have used that concept. But if the component size is more, then on that component we have to fix that, or we have to keep that sine bar in this way, and we have to measure the readings for this dial test indicator. So in heavy component, we can't mount the sine bar. Then sine bar is mounted on the component. So you can see that sine bar is mounted on the component. The height over the rollers can then be measured by vernier height gauge using a dial test gauge mounted on the anvil of height gauge as the fiducial indicator to ensure constant measuring pressure. The anvil on height gauge is adjusted with probe of a dial test gauge showing some reading of the topmost position of rollers of sine bar. So you will get the readings of R1 and R2 from the topmost position of the rollers. So the use of height gauge for obtaining two readings for either of the roller of sine bar. The difference of the two readings of height gauge divided by the center distance of sine bar gives the sine angle of the component to be measured. So whatever the difference between two readings divided by the center distance of sine bar, you'll get the angle theta. Here the greater accuracy is required. The position of dial test gauge probe can be sensed by adjusting a pile of slip gauges till dial indicator indicates same reading over roller of sine bar and the slip gauges. So in this way we can measure angle for the larger workpieces. So this is the way we can measure the angle for smaller component and larger component. So it is having some merits of sine bar. It is a precise and accurate angular measuring device. With the help of slip gauges and dial test indicator, we can measure precise and accurately angle. It is a simple design and construction. It easily available. So these are the merits of sine bar. Also, it is having some demerits. The establishment of an angle by the sine principle is an essential length measuring process Thus, the accuracy in practice is limited by measurement of center distance of two precision rulers. The geometrical conditions involve measuring the exact effective center distance existing between two rulers of the sine bar to a certainly a fraction of a micrometer is an infinitely complex problem. So any small error we are getting, that small error can be generate larger angular error. So we can measure the angles by using this sine bar less than 15 degree. Above 45 angle, it is difficult to measure or impractical because it is having some reasons that sine bar is physically clumsy to hold in that position for the angle above 45 degree. The body of sine bar obstructs the gauge block stack even if it is relieved. Slight errors of the sine bar cause large angular errors. Long gauge stacks are not nearly as accurate as shorter gauge blocks. So if you seen the, whenever we are building the dimension by using sine bar, so whenever we are taking the stack of these gauges, if larger gauges are added, then the error will be more. So that error will be getting into the theta value. Temperature variation becomes more critical and the difference in deformation occurs at the point of roller contact to the support surface and to the gauge block. Because of the higher angles, the weight load is shifted more towards the fulcrum of the roller. So these are the reasons because of that we are not getting impractical, or it is impractical to use sine bar above 45 degree. It is difficult to handle and position the slip gauges. Sometimes the sine bar is physically clumsy to hold in position. The application is limited to fixed center distance between two rollers. Slight errors of the sine bar causes large angular errors. So in this session, we have seen how we are going to measure the angle by using sine bar. So sine bar required slip gauges, also dial test indicators to measure the angles. So based on that, we can measure accurately the angle for the smaller component or larger component. So hope you like this video. If you like it, please stay connected and don't forget to subscribe my channel. If you want to cover any point regarding engineering background, please put that point name in the comment box. So we will prepare the video for this point. Thank you. Thank you very much.